a success in the final. Likeability, funny material, and mostly of all, he's got 96% battery. It's Lost Voice Guy!
I'm Lee, also known as the Lost Voice Guy, and I'm from Newcastle upon Tyne. Where I land, turn right. I have cerebral palsy, which means I can't talk. But when I'm performing, it's as if I've finally found my voice, and it's such a great feeling making people laugh. When I found out I was in the final,
Lost Voice Guy!
It was such an awesome feeling. It means the world to me. I was told to go out and smash it in my semi-final, but I think I took it too literally. When I got back to the hotel, I fell over. It would mean the world to me if I won Britain's Got Talent. My ultimate dream is to have a sell-out show in my home city of Newcastle. I'm so glad I decided to audition because it's changed my life. If I won, the prize money would mean I could develop a Geordie accent for myself. It's all gushty, bonny lad. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I know what you're all thinking. The fame has gone to his head. He's had a facelift, and it's almost as bad as Simon's. The truth is that after winning the semi-final, I went to the bar to celebrate. People kept asking if I wanted another drink. By the time I typed no, they bought me one. In the end, I fell over. So now I'm known as the Lost Balance Guy. It is also hard to interact with the audience when you use a computer, so please don't heckle me, or we'll be here all night. I will try to talk to someone, though. Hello, David. Are you having a nice time in this generic town or city?
Yes, thank you.
In a position where everyone can stare and laugh at me. The truth is that it happens to me every day anyway. At least this way there's a scheduled time and place for it. And because I want to be famous too. I started off in a disabled steps tribute band. We were called Ramps. Uphill struggle. I used to often think about going on the X Factor just to see the look on their faces when they realize I can't actually sing, or dance, or talk. But I'd like to play you a clip of what I think would happen if I did go on the X Factor. Don't you know I'm still standing better than I ever did? Looking like a true survivor. Feeling like a little kid. Still standing up for all this time. Picking up the pieces in my life without you on my mind. I'm still standing. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Finally, you've probably been wondering what I've been pressing on my tablet throughout the competition. The truth is that I've actually just spent the last 3 minutes voting for myself. I hope you had fun laughing at a disabled man. Goodbye.